Open up that crystal Pepsi and get comfortable.
This is Dope Nostalgia.
It's a double episode this week of Dope Nostalgia as we bring in our one-year anniversary. Of course, we have two episodes coming out at the same time, one with Kendra and Colin, my frequent guests, and we talked about all the great things and guests and conversations that we had this year in our very first year of the podcast. So you can get that one as well the same time as this one. By the way, I messed up the audio on my interview track, on my voice, really bad on this interview, so I ended up retracking it. You might notice it with the video on YouTube from this interview, that the gain is just cranked. So I had to go ahead and re-record all of my speaking parts on this interview. So if it sounds a little odd, that's why, okay? So forgive me. She's back. She's back for her second time on our show. The Queen of Rave is debuting her brand new single, I Feel It Slipping Away. You can find it on all digital music providers, and it's a jam, guys. The beautiful, talented, and lovely from London, England, this is Rozalla.
Naomi!
How are you?
How are you, my love? This is my husband. Come say hi.
Hello. Hi. I've just been setting up Zoom. I've just been rushing to get the makeup so she can make herself look more beautiful.
You guys are amazing. Even more beautiful. I remember the last time you were helping her set up and everything. You guys seem to have it all together.
It's very good.
Anyway, we need cheering up by you because we just got into tier four, so we're a bit down.
Ooh.
I know.
What does that mean? What does that mean? Like, are they talking about lockdown?
Full lockdown, basically.
Oh, just today they announced it?
Yeah.
Yeah, although I can still play golf, so I don't really care about anyone.
No, you can't. You can only play with one person, but you know. To be
anyway, honest. Hope it goes well. Bye.
Bye. Wow, eh? Yeah. Well, and also Merry Christmas, just around
Merry
the corner.
Yeah, exactly. Oh, well, this has knocked us all for six, I tell you. But there you go.
We got to do what we got to do, I guess, right?
Totally.
But there's hope around the corner now. We got the vaccine and all that. So.
Exactly. My husband said, look, if they're going to go on a stricter lockdown and it means everyone can return to their lives as normal as possible quicker, yeah. Let's do this. So...
Agreed.
Here we go.
Have you been able to do any performances last year?
Any what?
Were you able to do any performances last year or this year, 2020?
Only in August, I was able to do four social distancing gigs.
Hmm.
You know, and I thought, as I'm sure most people did, if this is a way forward until the vaccine comes, we'll take it.
Mm-hmm.
But then they started introducing other lockdowns, like bars to close at 10 p.m. Yeah. So how could you open nightclubs or do gigs when, you know,
there's no venues.
all the promoters thought it's,
and it's really difficult.
It's pointless.
I mean, even for doing like a festival, they had some interesting ideas of how you can have like these blocks of like tables to put people at and keep them apart, but that's just going to be logistically impossible.
And they did that. I mean, I did some gigs where they had them in pods. Some had pods, some had social distancing tables. And the one gig that I performed at, they were, and also the other thing, Naomi, they only allowed a certain amount of people. And this gig that I did, there were only 250 people were allowed, and it was out in the open. They're not allowed to have any indoors. Oh, no, forget that. Anyway, it was out in the open, and fortunately the day and the evening just was lovely. But you know, the adults, they're drinking, they're getting drunk, the songs come on, all that goes out the window. And that's what happened.
All inhibitions.
Everybody wants to dance and scream and jump on the stage. I mean, you know, when I went on and I told them, guys, you got to move back to your tables, you know, and then like, they all started walking back. And then as soon as the Everybody's Free started, the intro, they just went off, and they all started running back.
But that's what you want as a performer. You want to see people going wild and enjoying the moment. And it's kind of hard to perform for people when you have to like to be good and stay in one place, right?
Yeah. But here we are. here we are. So there's some positives, you know, and what to do? It's still a blow. It's still a sobering to hear your prime minister say, basically, you know, Christmas is cancelled, and you know, one of the scientists said the virus is mutating into something even worse.
Oh, yeah, I heard about that. I know.
I
was like,
I mean, when he said that, I had an interview before yours. I couldn't even do it because it was just after what he said, and I was like, and I said to Jonathan, my soul is just, I need to awaken it. You know, if I drank alcohol, I'd have had a shot of brandy, but I don't drink.
Yeah, it's probably for the best. Right now, I'll tell you, like, my weekends, I've had a little too much, let me tell you.
Drink one for me.
Cheers to you. On a positive note, did you discover any new hobbies or anything interesting while you've been in lockdown or throughout that last year?
Well, you know, like we spoke the last time, it's just, you know, I've discovered running, but then, you know, we live in a cold climate, England, and we're now in winter, and I kid you not, nearly every day it's been raining. So I could run, I guess, in the rain, you know, but then I don't get sick. You know, and then I've enjoyed running in the woods, but then it's muddy and I don't have to fall over, you know, so like I'm at home, but fortunately the gyms were open. So I was going to the gym, or I had a personal trainer coming out here when the gyms were closed to train me at home. So that kept me going. But now the gyms are closed.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
And I can't go out running or walking, but it's raining every day. But my husband said to me, look, we got a spin bike in the garage. We just do spin classes to YouTube or something. You know, we always find a way. You have to. Otherwise,
you got to be creative.
Yeah.
I got an elliptical now. So, like, what a relief. What a relief to have something. Because in Canada, it's already like, you know, Celsius, right? It's already minus 10, minus 20 here already.
Yeah. Where in Canada do you live again? I know you told me. I can't remember.
In Western Canada. So I'm in Edmonton.
Edmonton.
Yeah. So
Western Canada.
Yeah. So we're about a 6-hour drive north of the US border. We're the furthest northern city with a population of over a million.
All right. Yes, I remember you saying it was just a small city.
So it's cold. It's cold already.
Oh,
there's already
God.
A foot of snow on the
so
ground.
So you're in Edmonton, in Canada.
Mm-hmm.
Right. I'm going to look it up because my husband was interested. And I'm like, all I can remember was she said she lives in a small city that's on the edge of somewhere in Canada. Edmonton. I must remember Edmonton.
The edge of civilization. The edge of civilization there.
And it's cold. Is it cold right now? Like
right now it is. Let me here find the temperature for you. It's not that bad. It's 2 degrees.
Oh, okay.
2 degrees is good this time of year.
Oh, okay.
Because we're
okay.
Yeah. So it's better, but yesterday was like minus 15.
Wow.
Yeah.
And how long does it last for?
So like March, maybe April. You know, there's a lot of good things about living in Canada, but the trade-off is this weather.
Wow. Yeah. Oh my, I don't know what to say. Wow.
That's okay. I'm used to it. But back in normal times, I'd like to get away every winter in January. I like to go somewhere tropical.
How long would you go for when you go away?
A week.
A week.
Just a week.
And then.
And I try to go when it's like the worst week in Canada possible. Yeah. What's your bucket list vacation? Like, where is your one place that you're like, oh, that you haven't been yet?
Where I've been or haven't been?
Yeah, haven't been.
Goodness.
Yet.
Gosh. Obviously, anywhere sunny, you know. My husband and I have traveled quite a bit. Where haven't we been yet? Mind you, he's been saying quite a lot about, I don't know if it's sunny, it would depend on what year in time of year we went. He'd love to go to Nashville or Boston.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. Yeah, he'd
That'd
love
be very
to.
Cool.
Yeah, Nashville for the country music and Boston. Many, many years ago, I traveled to Boston for some gigs when I was signed to Sony. And they put me up in this grand hotel in Boston. And I just thought, this is like England. Yeah. Boston looked, the buildings looked like England. And then somebody said to me, yeah, it's very much like England. It wasn't like a city in America from what I was used to seeing, yeah. You know? And it was a bit chilly, and I just thought it was so pretty. So
reminds you of
yeah.
home.
Yeah.
It's probably because it's like the first American city, isn't it?
Yeah, pretty apparently. Much. Apparently. Yeah. Yeah. There's yeah. a story around it. I thought it was lovely. Yeah, really lovely.
Yeah, I'd like to see Boston as well. Now, you've been working hard, as you do have a new single we're going to play on the show.
And yes.
Tell us about making it and how it all came together.
Well, I feel it slipping away. Was sent to Gary, who runs Energize Records. Just him and his partner have been running it, I think, 25, 26 years now. And, you know, we've become really good friends. I've been with them for about 5 or 6 years. And we're working on an album, as you know, and Gary's been looking for songs for me and me, myself, and blah, blah, blah. And he sent me this track that was sent to him by Phil Harding, who's a good friend of Lamont Dozier. You know, Lamont Dozier was, to me, songwriting royalty from the days of Diana Ross, the Motown era. He used to write for all those artists, Diana Ross, Stevie Wonder, Smokey Robinson, and he sent Gary this track saying, you know, for one of your artists, and Gary heard it. Gary's like, this is up Rozalla Street. And this was never released as a single. It was done as a demo. Mm-hmm. And sometime I would believe in the 70s or 80s. And when Gary sent it to me, I thought, wow, Gary, we got to do this. Because I could hear what the song could turn out to be like, you know. So that's how that came about. And Gary and I were like also so floored that Lamont Dozier, who I believe is now in his late 70s or so, sent a personal message when he heard I'd done the track saying how blessed he felt that Energize had chosen that song and Rozalla's chosen to sing it. And we were like, wow, this is from songwriting royalty. You know, if you look up Holland and Dozier, they are the kings of songwriting from that era of the Motown legends. And we feel so honored.
No kidding. The song is, I love it. You've got a strong chorus there. It's a very good tune. So I can't wait to, gonna share it with everybody on the show and get people requesting it, you know, get it out there.
Thank you. Thank you. I want to thank them all in advance for their support. Thank you.
You better hurry. come back. I feel it slipping away.
How was the recording process doing this song when you're doing some recording from home, or did you go into the studio?
Well, fortunately, before we had lockdown one, we recorded quite a few tracks for the album, which included I Feel It Slipping Away. And so Gary had about all these tracks. I think we've got about 10 tracks already for the album, and we want about 12 or 15. So we've got another two more left to record. Obviously, we'll have to wait till this whole lockdown thing, you know.
That must be frustrating because you're so close now.
I know, but you know, Naomi, we've got about 10 out there, and they've currently been remixed and, you know, turned into something that'll be on the album. And I Feel It Slipping Away was one of them. And we got sent about three or four mixes for I Feel It Slipping Away. And Gary and I were like, yep, this is a follow-up to Magnificent, you know, which we released in May this year. And we were so fortunate enough to do a video for it because lockdown one had lifted, mm-hmm. and then we were able to mix, and then lockdown two was being introduced, and then Ash Stanley, who did the video, called me up. He's like, we've got to do a video, drive down to Derby, which like took me 2.5 hours to drive down to, or more, nearly 3 hours. And I left first thing in the morning. It was just the three of us in the studio, Ash, myself, and Yolandi, who helped me with the hair and makeup. And I just took a whole lot of clothes from my cupboard, and we just chose whatever. I took wigs, as you can see, one of them is the red wig. And we were in the studio for about 3 hours, just changing looks and doing this video. And so I'm so, so grateful that we were able to do that, because we weren't able to for Magnificent, because mm-hmm. that was released in the heart of the lockdown.
Mm-hmm. Well, yeah, I'm glad there was more opportunity with this single. And I mean, hopefully it just gets more opportunity going forward too after this.
I hope so.
How
I certainly hope so. How,
does this lockdown change your Christmas plans?
Yeah, absolutely. I mean, we were invited to some friends that literally live a 5-minute drive away from us, and they invited my husband and I for Christmas lunch and to spend the Christmas day with them. And she's an excellent cook, so I was so excited, you know. Mm. And then, of course, our prime minister tells us, no, not going to happen. But bless her, she said, look, I'll still cook and I'll bring it round to your house and leave it by the stairs outside. And we're like, no, don't worry. She's so, so lovely. But, so sweet of her. But the thing is, you know, like everyone, we want to follow the government guidelines and be good citizens about it and mm-hmm. do the right thing to the best of our ability.
What were your top three artists that you listened to in the 90s? And do you still listen to them? Like,
oh my goodness me. Wow. That's, oh Lord.
I got some new interesting questions for you.
that's a new one. Well, today I was just listening to Luther Vandross, mm-hmm. who I love. Who else was I listening to? I was listening to Barbara Streisand. Mm-hmm. There's so many. Who else from the 90s? Goodness me. I was listening to Baby D. Let me be a fantasy. And she's a good friend of mine.
That's so cool. I like that. What would be the, on a deserted island, what would album would you take with you? Or take more. Take three albums with you. Yeah.
Two albums. Well, one of them would have to be Luther Vandross's Greatest Hits.
Nice.
Right? And I'm not kidding you. I don't know who it is by, but when I have my bath, I listen to Bath Time Music, and they play all these, like, there's this Killing Me Softly with His Song. Mm. I love that song. But it's played by a person playing a piano and the guitar, you know? So a lot of those songs are very modern tracks, but have been done either by played by a guitar or piano, and it is so beautiful and so tranquil and so comforting to the soul. Mm. So I would have to take that, and it's called Bath Time Music. So I don't know what else to say.
stripped right down to the elements, and it's the best way. I think it's a good way to listen. You know?
Yeah, it's so beautiful. So if you can imagine, you know, I don't know, take a rock song, for instance. you know, I can't think of one at the moment. And it's just toned down and played by a beautiful guitarist or someone playing piano. And you're listening to the song and you're thinking, I know that, you know, and then the chorus might come, you go, ah, oh, that's that song, you know, and just done so beautifully. And yeah, it just has, makes me enjoy my bath even more and makes me feel more tranquil.
Now, as a dance artist, you do have the opportunity to, that's really cool, to always get your songs and get different mixes of each song. Do you ever sometimes, I think that's cool because it gives new flavor to the track every time, but do you ever find that you might like the remix better than the original, or does that happen sometimes?
With my songs?
Yeah, with your songs.
Well, yeah. I mean, you know, coming to I Feel It Slipping Away, we've got 3 or 4 mixes of it out there. You know, the main radio edit by Tony Moorcroft, the GNT mix. Mm. And then there's a funky mix. And then there was one mix that I hadn't heard before, which totally threw me. It's basically a cappella and with just the guitar and me singing. And it just took the song to a different level. And I'm thinking, this is fantastic, you know? And I shared it with my fans. And they were like, wow, we didn't know you had this a cappella mix, you know, which was fantastic. And then just recently, there's a well-respected DJ that he's based in New York. His name is Mark DeLang. And he wanted to do a mix of I Feel It Slipping Away. So Gary sent him the vocal stems. And he wanted the video as well. So he'd done his mix. And it is unbelievable. And he did it to a new video as well. And it's gone straight to number one in the Kings of Spin DJ chart. And it's been chosen by the DJs. So it's not sales or anything, but I feel so honored, you know, that it went straight to number one yesterday in their chart. And I'm going, okay, this is nice.
Awesome.
This is nice. So how one song can spin into so many different facets because of a different mix is just, has always been amazing to me.
Oh, no kidding. I mean, and it must be exciting for you to hear it once the new product is done. Like, I don't know. I think it's from those most exciting feelings is when you're hearing something for the first time after it's been mixed and mastered.
Yeah, it's wonderful. It really is. It really is. And I don't know if you remember, I did a track called Turn on the Light, which was released 2018. And we just let that run and run because it had its own kind of success. We had about 600 stations playlisted, which we thought, wow. And then Mark DeLang has said he wants to try mixing that one as well. So we might have a resurgence of that song in 2021. Who knows?
Do it.
Who knows?
Oh, that would be
beautiful. Yeah, we're going to do it.
Do you collect memorabilia, vinyl, stuff like that? Do you have a collection of things from your career? I know, obviously, there's wonderful photos behind you.
Yes, I do. Well, as you can see, the poster over there, that's the Everybody's Free album sleeve, you know, and the other ones you can't see very well. The smaller pictures are when I supported Billy Ocean and when I supported Michael Jackson. There's the red one, that's me and MJ himself. And then there's others where I'm actually on stage doing the stadium for Michael Jackson. And they were taken in such a way whereby, you know, they were zoomed in from sort of behind the crowd and to me. So I look really tiny. But what's so amazing is how many people are in the stadium. And that to me will always forevermore be a shocker. You know, so it brings me fast forward to what we're going through now with COVID. You know, when will we ever return to something like that? I sincerely pray and I hope we will do. And we will do, but when?
Exactly.
Is the question.
It's a matter of when.
Yeah, it's a matter of when.
Where do you like to go? Do you still like to go out dancing? Let's pretend there's no COVID. Do you like to go out dancing?
No, I used to. Not really anymore. I'm not, you know, as a performer, I go out to do my shows. And even when I do my shows now, I prefer to leave straight away and go home. Either come home or go to my hotel room and watch something on TV or Netflix. That's my party time.
Oh, yeah. Relaxing and relaxing.
Yeah, that's my party time. Or, you know, when I've done a gig, I just can't wait to come back home and go to the hotel room, have a bath, stay in the bubble bath and, what I'm going to watch on, you know, on Netflix or whatever. But I think if I went out dancing, my favorite thing would be actually to go to a private party, you know, rather than to a nightclub. I think I'm past the nightclub stage now.
I think I was past that stage at like 22.
Exactly.
It was over very fast.
We're all grown up. That's what I'm saying. A party now with, you know, your peers that are the same age group or whatever. For me, I find more inviting. Yeah.
Do you play board games or card games?
Do I what?
Do you play board games or card games or things like that?
You know what? No, I don't. Yeah. My husband does. He's forever playing these games and he's like... you know, you look up and go, I'm not ignoring you. It's all good for the brain, you know. It's keeping my brain's exercise. I'm like, yeah, you just keep playing those games.
He's not wrong. It is.
No, I don't. Naomi, my favorite pastimes is watching movies or watching. Right now I'm watching a TV show on Prime, Amazon Prime, which is like Netflix, but it's a different kind of thing. And I'd heard about it when it first came out in 2018, The Handmaid's Tale.
Yes.
Which I believe was filmed in Canada, I believe, or something like that. And I'd heard so much about it. And I just didn't like, yeah, you know, there's so much else to watch. And I decided, because I went to visit some friends last week, and they're like, oh, you have to watch it. Oh, you have to watch it. I am now on season 2, and I've only been watching it for like 4 days. Season 2, I don't know. Nice. I can't. My husband's like, you're obsessed. It is like one of those. It's just shocking. It's shocking, and you think it can't get any worse, but it does.
Mm-hmm.
So I'm like, I want to see this to the end. Yeah.
What's my binge right now? I said the one I just finished was The Crown on Netflix.
Oh yes. Yeah.
And I'll watch that one straight through, like in 2 days. And then I have to wait a year. And then and it's a good thing it's a story we already know, right? So you don't forget about it in a year.
Yeah, exactly. Exactly. Oh, goodness.
But yeah, like, I understand. That's a good one. Mandalorian, that's a good one. That's on that Disney channel. But yeah, it's a good time to just kick back and try to enjoy some shows while.
Well, you know, yeah. at the moment with this lockdown that we've been put through, there is nowhere to go now unless you go grocery shopping and maybe go and browse in the shops, in the grocery shops. I don't know.
I try to avoid them because that's where sometimes you run into like the worst people.
Right. Exactly. So honestly, you want to spend as little time in the grocery shop and just be at home and watch TV and make time for exercise and conversation and eat good food and just pray for this virus to disappear out of this world of ours.
Take some vitamins and take care of your health and your mental health especially.
100%. The mental health thing, believe me, you know, I think even the strongest of persons mentally has been highly affected by this some way or the other, because it's just like you just want to get back to your normal life, you know what I mean? But it is what it is, Naomi. And I looked up an article and I saw that every 100 years, a pandemic hits the world.
Yep. We always get through it. Yep, we always get through it.
Yeah. And those people over 100 years ago have come through because it didn't end the world then. No. You know, humanity lived on.
Yeah.
And you know, thank goodness for clever people out there, clever scientists, you know, bless them all for all the work that they're doing.
And in a positive note, too, usually there's a real huge upsurge after a pandemic. With the roaring 20s.
Right.
You know, so.
Right.
Yeah. Everything goes really much better after a pandemic ends. So we do have that to look forward to, I hope.
Yeah, exactly. Exactly. As they say, how do they put it? I'm probably going to get it wrong. The storm before the calm.
Yeah.
Storm is what we're going through, and we will go through calm and thing. We're going to have such a big party. We're going to do great. Yeah. You got to believe that.
And doing stuff like this, having these chats and making a show and making music. These are the things that are keeping us creative and, you know, it's good.
Yeah,
it's a good time to be creative.
Absolutely. And honestly, Naomi, it's one of the things that's helped to keep me going mentally is, you know, having had Release Magnificent, and you kindly, did an interview with me then, and, doing an interview now. And it's all been part and parcel of making me feel some kind of normalcy towards my career. Like, I'm putting something out there. I'm still doing something, even though I'm not able to go out and perform, et cetera, et cetera. I will take this any day, and it fills me with joy, that I'm doing something. Mm-hmm, yeah. Mm-hmm. And the same for you as well. You interviewed me and vice versa.
Yeah. And this is going to be our 1 year anniversary episode. So it's really cool to celebrate our 1 year with you.
Wow. Thank you. Wow. That's brilliant. Cheers. Cheers. I don't have anything, but I got my lip gloss. I bought some lip gloss today. So cheers.
Cheers. Here's some of my water for you. But yeah, thank you again for your time. And I can't wait to share the song.
Oh, my darling. It's been such a joy. I feel like you've become my best friend now.
Yes, BFF. We'll have to do this
so
again.
So we've got each other's numbers and et cetera, et cetera. And I'm always here. And no doubt we'll be speaking in 2021 because I've got more singles coming out and the album.
Oh, good.
So I'll be sharing that with you. Jonathan and I will be tapping on your door vigorously.
Do it. Our listeners will be very excited for it. So thank you, Rozalla.
Thank you.
It's always a pleasure.
My darling, thank you. Listen, have a very Merry Christmas, Naomi, and the very best for 2021, and keep warm.
Oh, yes.
In your country. And I want to look up where Edmonton is, because Alan wanted to know, where's Edmonton?
Yeah, check it out. It's one of the biggest malls in the world.
Yes, I remember you saying that. You should tell me that. Because I'm already saving money to come to that mall.
There's a water park in the mall. There's a huge ice rink in there for skating and hockey. Of course, it's Canada, right? But and a big, huge boat like the Santa Maria. It's massive.
Wow. Is it? There obviously is a cinema in there as well.
Oh, yeah. There's a theater. There's an amusement park with an indoor roller coaster in it. Tripper Loop roller coaster.
What?
Yeah.
Mike, I'm going to look it up. I am going to look it up. This is very dangerous territory for me. Very dangerous. I'm trying to save, I've not been having any money. Thank you very much. I'll just send you the bill. That's what I'll do.
I'll take you when you come. I'll take you to the water park and to the amusement park.
It will be dangerous for both of us. Oh, my gosh.
You live in a climate like this, you have to have all of that indoors.
Jeez, I tell you. Oh, my goodness. This is dangerous. Yeah. Wonderful.
Guess what, friends? I have a new voicemail number just for you.
Give us a call at Dope Nostalgia. Our number is 780-851-8785.
Leave us a message. Pick up the phone, just like you used to in the old days. Remember, before text messaging? Yeah, we used to actually call each other.
If you just want to be heard and be on the podcast, give us a call. Once again, our Dope Nostalgia hotline, 780-851-8785. Pick up the phone.
Remember, this number is Canadian, so long-distance charges may apply.
Social media, yeah, we've got it. Send us an email, dopenostalgiapodcast@gmail.com. Twitter, nostalgiadope. Or on Insta, dope_nostalgia.
This podcast is licensed by SoCan because we believe that artists should be paid for their work.